From revelations of 200 million shillings for cars meant for close to 150 MPs, 68 million shillings for burial expenses, receiving a sack of sugar, and 1 million shillings by a section of MPs are issues that have angered the public. Last week, the media was awash with stories of what had become of Parliament, a move which even saw the Speaker, Honorable Rebecca Kadaga, threaten to gag the media. In view of this, the opposition FDC party has challenged the August House to swallow the bitter pill of public criticism.
You'll find that every year we nearly spend more than 50 billion shilling barring people. And the people we are barring are the ones who are working. The other day, I think a report on treatment abroad was nearly 200 billion shilling per year. So you are the one who are being treated abroad when you are sick. You are the one who wants vehicles. You want your funeral also to be a ceremony. So everything good you want to yourself. Maybe when we grow the economy of this country and everybody can afford a decent life, then you can go back and also begin living the way we want. But otherwise, to expect the public to keep quiet when they see these things happen and they continue languishing is to be asking too much.
The party has hailed the Speaker's move to defer the age limit bill, a private member's document proposed by Nachifuma County MP Robert Sechitoleko.
We would like to extend our thanks to the Speaker for having stopped the premature and unnecessary debate on a motion moved by Nachifuma MP Sechitoleko, seeking leave of parliament to introduce a bill, what you ordinarily should call a satanic bill, whose intention is to keep Chigundu and his commissioners at the Electoral Commission.
Honorable Semuju added that there were plans by the Electoral Commission boss, Badru Chigundu, to lobby MPs to extend his term in office, which is set to expire in November this year.
By now, we expect Chigundu and his team to be bidding farewell, apologizing for what they have done wrong, because even by court, not once, but court has repeatedly denounced the elections organized under Chigundu. In this cycle, you've seen more than nearly now 30 MPs have lost their elections because of the non-compliance of Chigundu and his team. It is only an insane person like Kafero who can say that Chigundu, who has failed to organize elections as they are ordered by the Constitution, should continue serving with his commission. The same applies to the age of judges. I am aware, and we have told you, that Chigundu specifically has been calling MPs. You can imagine that professor calling MPs, pleading with them that, please, can you amend the constitution so I continue serving in the Electoral Commission? I am told even Kavuma at Court of Appeal, because Kavuma, by next year, Kavuma should also be retiring.
Members of Parliament on the opposition have referred to the ongoing public uproar against the August House as an intended diversion plotted by government. The media, though, has been dragged into the Parliament public confrontation by MPs who have been singled out.
What we need to do is revise the policy. At least personally, I'll be in support of reducing the number of government people that will give vehicles. For example, at Parliament, we can give the Speaker and Deputy Speaker and Leader of Opposition and maybe the clerk. Even senior staff of parliament can be helped to go and borrow and buy vehicles, including us members of parliament. The MPs can go and borrow. Government can help them access a soft loan.
FDC spokesperson has raised concern that there is need to revise the policy about transporting the government officials, adding that the opposition cannot be excluded from public criticism. This story was compiled by Maria Nachambade, WBS TV, Kampala.